Received a young boy into the emergency department during one of the mass casualties who had half of his face and neck blown off. Luckily, the organs that are vital for breathing and blood supply to the brain were preserved. They were visible, but preserved. And he was talking to us. His entire family, parents and the rest of his siblings, were killed in the same attack. That boy survived. And the next day, I went to see him. A very young plastic surgeon, one of the few remaining plastic surgeons in Gaza, had removed part of his chest and created a graft to cover those vital organs of the neck. He was lying in his bed and mumbling because it was so difficult to talk. And he kept saying, I got really close to him and he said, I wish I had died too. And I said, what? And he said, I think my entire family has gone to heaven. It's not my entire family. His exact words were something effective. Everybody I love is now in heaven. I don't want to be here anymore. That is one of so many stories. I'm so sorry, Leila, but I think people need to hear this.
كيف كنت بتحس وانت مضطر تعمل عملية بدون تخدير؟
بتحسي حالك انك مجرمة. صعب انك تسمعي صريخ اي انسان انت عم بتسببي بألامه، حتى لو بسبب الحاجة. يعني كانت من اصعب التجارب.
هل كان في بديل؟
ما كان في بديل. احنا خلال اسبوعين ثلاث اسابيع من الحرب انتهى المورفين. صرنا نعطي المرضى اللي بنعمل لهم عمليات بنادول كمسكن. في واحد عنده بتر بدراعه من كتر ما كان الوضع صعب عنده. كان في يرقات الدبان جوا الجرح وتحولت الى ديدان يعني، وما كان عندي خيار الا انه بالصابون انظف له الطرف المبتور. وبعدين أذكر مسكت أنينة الخل وكلها حطيتها على الجرح لأنه كان مات بدون هيك
يعني. نسبة التحمل عند الناس مختلفة.
بتصرخ لآل بس.
Two populations are particularly vulnerable. Pregnant and lactating women who were already facing iron deficiency anemia before the war, which puts them at risk for hemorrhage during birth. With the war, it puts them in a state of undernourishment or malnutrition, potentially malnutrition, which means that they can't breastfeed their children properly. The milk doesn't necessarily come in, and it's definitely not enough. And the other population is children under 2 years, which is the breastfeeding age. Those children need to be breastfed. If they can't be breastfed, they need formula. To have formula, you need clean water. None of these things are possible. What we're talking about is women who are squeezing fruits, dates into handkerchiefs, into tissues, and feeding their children with some sort of sugary substance to nourish them. The consequences of this over the long run mean that there is a lack of bond between the mother and the child. It means that there are physical and psychological delays for these children to develop. And in the future, for those children who do grow up, it means that they are more at risk of having high blood pressure, of having diabetes and other complications.
بيقول لي جهزوا قسم الطوارئ فلقد تم قصف مستشفى المعمداني بالفعل وهناك المئات من الجرحى والشهداء وكنت من بين الطواقم في قسم الطوارئ لأرى ذلك المشهد الذي لم أرى مثيلا له في حياتي لا في السينما ولا في الخيال ولا حتى في أقصى درجات ما يمكن أن يتخيل الإنسان من الإجرام. رأيت هؤلاء الأطفال ممزقة أشلاؤهم ورأيت هؤلاء الأطفال الذين بترت رؤوسهم. اليوم ونحن نرى هذه الجريمة المركبة وهذه الأعداد التي لم يستطع معها الكادر الطبي إلا أن يجري العمليات في الممرات وإلا أن يجري العمليات حتى بدون تخدير ليسعف ما يمكن إسعافه، لكن كانت يد الغدر سباقة بإيقاع المئات من الشهداء والإصابات في هذه المجزرة التي إنما أتت تحت سمع العالم وبصره.